This experiment shows the principle of function of galvanic cell, called voltaic cell as well. It serves as a source of voltage by changing chemical energy to electric energy. Galvanic cells differ into two types, primary and secondary cells. Here you can see the simplest primary cell possible. It consists of an electrolyte, salt water in this case, zinc as a negative electrode, and copper as a positive electrode. If we put the electrodes into the electrolyte, zinc electrode will start to dissolve and zinc cations will be released into the solution. The zinc electrode will be negatively charged because the electrons stay inside. Copper electrode will dissolve less, that's why it will have smaller negative charge. Towards the zinc electrode, it will have positive charge. If we connect the cell to an appliance, for example an LED, electric current will flow through the circuit and the diode will shine. But not without assistance of a small device called Joule thief. Joule thief is a simple voltage booster. It can use nearly all of the energy in a single cell power supply, even far below the voltage where other circuits consider the supply fully discharged. It consists of an NPN transistor, a resistor, and a ferrite toroid with a copper wire wrapped around it. The reason why the light-emitting diode would not shine without a Joule thief is that a galvanic cell produces only 1 volt of voltage, while the diode needs full 3 volts to function.